Right, so good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for staying awake. So I'm just going to talk very briefly about a big part of my PhD research, which is, as you can see here, doing a thorough systematic reappraisal of fossil elephantids, which I think are a very interesting group to look at from macroevolutionary perspective, given that their quite modest extant diversity is completely dwarfed by the very considerable fossil record of some nearly 40 species, including some of the largest land mammals to have walked the earth, such as the Eurasian Pleistocene mammoth and Paleoloxodon. It is also worth noting that elephantid evolution had a lot of similarities with the evolutionary history of our own lineage, the hominins, both having originated and undergone some early taxonomic radiation in the late Neogene of Africa before dispersing to other parts of the world and undergoing some further diversification. And finally, towards the late Pleistocene, there was a great collapse in taxonomic diversity, leaving only one species of human and three species of elephants surviving today. So a big incentive for me to look at this is because a lot of the consensus on elephantid systematics are still heavily reliant on the pre-cladistic works of people like Vincent Maglio. This summary phylogram by Maglio is more or less what the current consensus represents. You can see that Elephas is thought to be very closely related to the extinct Eurasian Paleoloxodon, but recently there has been some unpublished molecular data which actually shows that Paleoloxodon is much more closely related to the extant African elephant or Loxodonta. So this implies major morphological convergence that has gone on in elephantid evolution, and we have to critically interrogate the accepted status quo. And one of the problems with previous works on elephantid systematics is that they were heavily reliant on teeth that are subject to very considerable parallelisms throughout their evolutionary history, as well as intraspecific variability. So for my work on elephant phylogeny, I'm focusing on aspects of cranial morphology, which means sitting in the museum collections, staring at a big specimen, crying, "How on earth am I gonna maneuver it?" But nonetheless, as previously stated, there are some critical questions we have to address, such as the homology issues between the crania of Paleoloxodon and Elephas that look superficially similar with their very heightened overall build and very pronounced projection of the skull dome. In fact, previous authors such as Marco Ferretti and Saigosa Haruo have written about homology issues in these structures prior to the emergence of new molecular results. And another aspect of my work has been looking at phylogenetic utility of novel characters that have been overlooked, such as the lacrimal complex, this part of the skull. So for instance, in Loxodonta, the African elephant, we see a thick lateral wall of the major infraorbital foramen that strongly recedes medially, as well as a small cylindrical lacrimal tubercle in the eye socket. In terms of the lacrimal tubercle part, you can see here that it is quite similar to what we see in Paleoloxodon, but it's interesting how in Paleoloxodon, the lateral wall of the major infraorbital foramen is much thinner and adopts a much more standing angle, which is similar to what you see in Elephas, the Asian elephant, as well as the extinct mammoths. And also in terms of the lacrimal tubercle, what me and a collaborator, Marco, has found is that the lacrimal tubercle of Asian elephants and mammoths both tend to show a much more conical shape, the difference being a basal foramen that is often present in Asian elephants, which you don't see on mammoths. So here's a preliminary. So here's my preliminary tree, which you can see doesn't hold much hope for the future, with some pitifully low bootstrap support values for the 50% majority consensus topology on the maximum parsimony, and also we failed to reject the phylogenetic distinction of Palaeoloxodon from elephas. Also worth noting is how Anancus, which is one of my outgroups, has nested inside the Elephantids. But I suppose a lot of it is a data artifact, since this subset of characters I use doesn't include any tooth characters, which is actually the major difference that separates the outgroups of the elephants, the Gomphotheres, and Elephantids. So in looking further ahead, dental characters are still important. I will definitely be experimenting with Bayesian algorithms to build my phylogeny, given the quite prevalent of recent trends in pontificating that parsimony is dead. When the molecular study gets published, it will definitely be worth playing around with both molecular and morphological data to construct, but also place time constraints on the various terminals in my phylogeny. And so in a couple of months' time, I will be heading to China to work on these excellent newly discovered early mammoth materials. So finally, a step mammoth-sized thank you to everyone who has encouraged me and inspired me to take on this very challenging research project, as well as the various curators in different institutions that have provided me access to their specimens. A big shout out to the ProcPal Travel Grant and the University of Bristol Alumni Foundation for supporting my travel to Leicester to attend this conference. And finally, a big thank you to Mark Puttick for helping me to run my first phylogenetic analysis. Thank you very much.